The trend cursor allows you to find out real specifics about the values on a trend. Let me open up a new display, demonstrate this trend cursor. Now, first of all, you have to go over to the very leftmost to the y-axis, and you should see your cursor change to this trend cursor icon. You can click and drag one or more of these trend cursors out there. The trend cursor shows me the value and the timestamp down at the bottom. So any of these trends will support it as long as the trend is currently big enough to support, you know, the trend cursor given the font that you've selected. So for example, I want to find out when this peaked. I can just drop it right there. I know that's at 237. And likewise on this vertical trend, I'd have to do this on the y-axis for the vertical trend, which ends up being up here. And there's my trend cursor for the vertical trend. Now this works as well if you've got multiple tags on a trend. Let me show you multiple tags. This is more than one. Now in this case, you'll notice that the trend cursor itself is not available. I can tell that it's not available because this icon over here, this is the trend cursor icon, the icon's grayed out. It's grayed out because there's simply not enough room to show the trend cursor on this trend given its size and the current font. Now, if I were to expand this, you'll notice the trend cursor is not grayed out. It's available just fine. And by the way, this trend cursor icon is another way of adding trend cursors. If you're not real steady-handed with coming over here and grabbing this, you can just click on the trend cursor. It deposits a trend cursor that you can then pick up and move. So if you're not the best at lining up those y-axis, you can go ahead and use the trend cursor like that. That's going to add and remove a trend cursor. As you can see, it works for more than one trace at the trend at the same time, and as many of these trend cursors as you need to put on there. By the way, maybe it's obvious, but the solution to not being able to show a trend cursor here if it's too small is to just make this bigger. Make this bigger, and then you'll see the trend cursor without any difficulty.